Yo!
Hi, everybody.
I got so excited.
We're here.
Earth. What's up, everybody? Welcome. Apologies in advance if there's a little bit of this room tone, or if this might get
muted
later,
or if this shakes a little bit. You know, we got some minis going. We're here in foggy, except for actually gorgeous weather.
Oh my gosh.
It's been great.
It's like they did it for us. Like they knew we were going to be
here. Maybe they did, but I'm going to go and say they did.
It's so nice out.
Yeah.
Hello, everybody. Welcome. It's cool. We got Birdman up here. We got some quicksand. We have some stateside folk because it's 6 a.m.
Yeah.
West Coast time, but it's not unreasonably early for other folks.
It's not that
so bad. Good morning to you all. We're actually ahead of you instead of behind for once, which is cool.
Sorry if this gets muted afterwards.
Again, I said for some people it's not too early. Sakura said it's so early. Unfortunately, the West Coast is still 6 a.m., which is
quite
early.
Need to be watching if you're on the West Coast.
The one thing that's nice is the time has changed in America, but it has not yet changed here in Britain. So we're only 7 hours ahead from
that
the West Coast instead of 8 for like a week. And then it's going to be 8 again. So
yeah. And I'm glad, Birdman. Thank you. He said for remote, it looks / sounds great. Don't even sweat.
Good.
That's awesome. Thank
you.
There's
gonna be some room tone, but we're in a happening.
So yeah, let's talk about
Oregon Café. So we're in Draughts, Waterloo.
Yes.
There's two Draughts, and it's in London here. The I is just that
it's
way.
Like right
the
over
Thames,
there.
And then Big Ben is just over there in Parliament stuff.
Yeah.
So we're right in the hood, and we're actually under a railway station. In this really cool tunnel that last time Nick was here, like 12 years ago, what's going on in this tunnel?
So this tunnel here, you can't really see it, but it's...
We'll take a picture in here,
we'll probably tweet it. Yeah, on the outside of this...
This is holding up trains, that.
Yes, so if you hear a train, it's because there's a train going on above us.
Yeah.
This tunnel, it's this big tunnel, but graffiti is legal in here. So there's so many cool artists who come in here and they just do graffiti and it's beautiful. The whole thing, the roof, everything is covered. And it constantly gets painted over and covered again, painted, people just all the time. It's very, very cool.
Do you think
cool.
It'll ever paint to the point that it'll be closed off?
Yes.
Because there's so many paint layers?
Yeah, so we eventually just, you're kind of crawling.
I heard a thing recently.
Paint in there like this.
That it says this, every time you paint your house, it grows. And every time you paint your room, it shrinks.
That's true.
Because there's a layer of paint.
I mean, technically, it would take an incredibly long time. But technically, you could paint a room closed.
Yeah.
Yes. It would take an incredibly long time.
You can paint a house into a mansion.
Yes, exactly.
And you carve out the paint layers, and then they have extra room.
That's how it works.
But so, Missy. Hello, Missy.
Hi, Missy.
Good to see you back.
It is staying alive playing. Sorry, GenCon, if this gets muted afterwards.
I'm not apologizing. It's dope. We have the ripping stream.
But,
yeah.
And hey, thank you, Cheryl, for the sub. Appreciate you.
Hey, good
but
morning,
so,
Cheryl.
So this.
Good afternoon.
This here tunnel now apparently has shops in it. 10 years ago, this didn't have shops.
Yeah.
Because 10 years ago, that's when they started doing this. This the graffiti in here. So we came in here and we were looking for this place, and it's inside this awesome. We'll take a picture out here afterwards.
It's super cool.
And it's so cool. And so we came in. Asked if we could live stream because we needed somewhere that had Wi-Fi and stuff, and they said
and fine.
Now it did help that one of the people here knew who we were, so that
it always helps your case if you're trying to go into a place and be like, oh hey, it's a Brothers Murph, where it's like, see, we're not
can we live stream here or what?
Talking to a rando trying to explain all these things, they're like, what do you want to do? And someone's like, oh, it's a Brothers Murph. We're like, yeah, see, we're not lying. We do whether or not we should,
but
we
it's
do
honestly,
stuff on the internet.
This place is very cool.
It's very cool.
Let's give a little real quick if we can. Just kind of try and let's blow us up, obviously.
Oh, hi.
Hi, everybody. But I'm going to take a...
He's going to take you around the room.
Not going to take you around the room too much. But we'll
show you the room.
Yeah. So this is Draughts.
Drafts.
I would say Draught. I'm sorry.
Drafts.
Really cool. Got a little upstairs inside this like cool tunnel area thing.
Yeah.
Super, super cool.
We've got either Efka or Elaine. We've got either Efka or Elaine, no pun included, up in here. And oh yeah, that's Waterloo. Yeah, we're in Waterloo.
Oh yeah, we're in Waterloo.
and how the heck are you? No pun included. Good to see you in the web. It'll be awesomer to see you in person soon.
Can't wait to meet you too.
Oh no. is the Hackney one cool? Have you been to both?
We came to this one because it was a little closer.
Yeah. Sakura's off to work. Have a great day. Have a good day at work. Birdman says, weird question. Is there a manager of Draughts named Adam dyed blonde hair?
Not that we saw.
But maybe.
One of the guys who works here is named Michael, and then the one who knew who we were was named Nick. So
it worked out.
Two Mikes and
Nicks.
It worked out. Yeah.
So.
Yeah, we're at Waterloo.
The Waterloo.
But yeah, so thank you for being here. So yeah, so we're going to paint some minis. We did bring some minis. We brought all of our contrast paints because you just take them right out of the pot and put them on there.
We've got some international corn demons now because we brought them across the pond.
I can't. Never mind. So we
might just rock out for this entire time.
So yeah, if we're a little quiet, it's because there's awesome music. This place is really, really cool. And we're probably going to play some games here afterwards. It's going to be great.
Emma, have a good day at work. Which time to eat all the LaCroix. I'm drinking a nice old Jamaica ginger beer at the moment, which is delicious.
I have Diet Coke, which is better here?
I don't know. It's about the same. It's pretty dang similar. Like, we were having Diet Coke the other night, and I was just like, I don't think there's a difference. Not that I can tell. I don't know. Anyway.
But yeah, so we have all our contrast paints up here. We brought some paint brushes, and we got our lovely, for all of our Brits, we bought this little mug to wash our water in, our dirty paint water.
Yeah, we bought a Briton mug for £4.99. Not a bad deal.
Indeed.
We'll drink out of it later, but it's not like it just puts our dirty paints in there. It's not a statement about the country, so don't take it as such. I hope.
But yeah, so we're here.
Rosie says, too early for this. You've been up since three hours.
Come on. Yes, it is a bit early. But we're happy that we were able to do this more or less at our normal times. We're still gonna try and do our Monday streams, but they're gonna be at some weird time. I don't know when.
No pun included, said we're such tourists. We are. We literally went into like a tourist specific shop right across the street and tried to find deliberately one of the mug that looks the most touristy.
Yeah,
this is pretty dang touristy.
Pretty dang.
But also one that would cost a lot. I don't want to pay gouging tourist prices. So $5 seemed okay.
Rosie said, I've been up for the last 3 hours, but that's not the point. That's not the point.
It's too early for all of life.
Yeah, it's gonna be a good day. So yeah, so we do have some more corn demons here. One thing that I'll say, there's not anything I can do about the autofocus, so sorry about that. Just please, Dev. We're gonna paint some corn demons with a little bit of.
Fuzzy Logic says try dandelion and burdock when you go to the north. It's a soft drink with an interesting taste. Matthew Jude has talked about this.
Yes.
Specifically, they say it's like their version of root beer. It's another root beer type thing. It's not the same, obviously, but I'm incredibly excited, and that is like one of my top priorities is to try that exact drink. So.
Said a Monday. How long will you be there? A while. We're coming home next Saturday.
A week from Saturday.
Not this Saturday, but next Saturday is when we're coming back. So yeah, the 21st. So we're here for like almost 2 weeks because we wanted to spend some time with Matthew Jude, and it's been great.
Dat Jude. No, but who's a dandelion and burdock is foul. How dare you?
You don't even
besmirch this drink I've never had. You're probably right. I'm probably gonna like it. I don't know.
You'll probably like it. I have a feeling you'll like it, but I won't.
Probably.
You know what I mean?
I like weird stuff. I like things that are like, anything that's like, it's an acquired taste. I'm like, get competitive. Like, well, I'm going to acquire it then, damn it, through brute force. Whether or not that's healthy, I don't know. But I'm going to make you drink some. We're gonna have a taste test together. I'm going to see you do a scowl face when you try it.
I'm having so much fun. We're in London.
Me too. This is so cool. We've been having a really good time. We'll get to painting eventually, or maybe soon. We're going to use our contrast paints, by the way.
I said we're using contrast paints.
I wasn't listening.
Painting some corn demons. We're going to paint it. We've only used contrast paints a bit, and we only had these two minis. We're going to try and pick up some more minis maybe at Aircon. So next Wednesday when we're streaming, we have something else to paint. But nonetheless, oh my gosh. What did you do?
What?
He's got a boomerang. Got a boomerang axe right here. What is this?
It wasn't broken when I handed it to you.
What is this? This boomerang axe? It's probably because he was in a bag full of these.
Yeah, that happened.
So he's holding the most scary axe.
What if he's just swinging it so hard that it's literally bending mid-swing?
But if
he's
swinging it this way, this is from the back swing.
Yeah, no, that's his windup. That's how hard his windup is. Cheryl says, funny, you're in London listening to Boston. That is true.
That is accurate.
Missy says, do we get to meet Matthew's twin?
Not yet.
Prove that he's real. Matthew's already started to lay the groundwork saying like, he might be busy working. I don't know if he's going to be around.
What a bastard.
Convenient. We'll see.
Yeah, convenient.
All right. So, what Are you going to try to kind of keep this classic Khorne demon style? Because I'm going to really follow you today. I think I'm going to try to go more classic with the reddish skin. We're going to do contrast paints and see how that
works.
Talking
about that. Yeah, it's because you can't like highlight with contrast paints. Because not really paints. They're more like washes.
Yeah.
So it's going to be kind of interesting to... I don't really know.
Yeah.
I don't really know, honestly. I am trying to decide.
Birdman says, ooh, and did Paula's twin make the trip? Did Laura Matthews' twin hit it off? Maybe that's where this mysterious Laura Deming is with Matthews' twin.
When will it die?
If ever that proves to be real. If Paula's been lying to us this whole time, we'll see.
We'll see. But no. Because Laura Deming doesn't exist, call her Paula.
This guy's got a pretty serious, like, oh... So this demon here, I think, was chained up at one point and ripped it off.
Probably.
It just kept the thing like a barbed wire armband thing.
So now I'm trying to think, like, what should I do for his skin here?
I was thinking about doing, like, the Blood Angels red.
That's, like, red, I think.
Well, aren't they supposed to be, like, red?
Not their skin. Their armor is red.
Well, but the guy you painted was, like, all red.
That's because I haven't done any highlights on it yet.
No.
Yeah.
What are you going to highlight it to? Because remember, I was doing like a couple weeks ago, I've been working on this like a frost version of a Khorne demon because I thought they have red skin, you said.
No, they have red. They're red armor. All their armor and stuff is red.
What skin color are they?
Whatever you really want to make it. But they tend to be very pale.
So my frost demon thing is not even that unique then.
No, because they're not generally, they don't have blue skin. They're not Smurfs.
I thought I was making the coolest thing ever.
You are, but not in the way that you are. Think you are.
Nicholas.
Yeah, no, Khorne demons are, they're all their armor, all their stuff is red. They
I
always
thought
have
the guy
red.
You were painting was shirtless.
No. He is shirtless.
But you painted him red.
I painted him a dark, dark skin tone because I'm going to be highlighting his skin up.
To what?
To, like, white.
Are you
not
serious?
Not white, but like to a pale skin tone, yes.
You're blowing my mind right now.
You're so ridiculous.
You're lying.
No, you're ridiculous.
Oh my goodness.
So okay, I'm trying to figure out what color to do. Do whatever you want, honestly.
I don't want to make him red. I'm going to make him like a demon. He's a demon.
What's Fire Slayer Flesh? I don't honestly remember what this called.
I'm either going to make him that or literally yellow and make him look like Khorne on the Cob.
Don't you besmirch imaginary love. You're good, Birdman. Okay, so that's okay. So that's kind of a dark one.
Like a brown?
Yeah, it's kind of a dark brown.
Fire Slayer.
So again, so the thing is, like, we only have contrast paint, so I kind of want, like, a pale one. But, like...
Like Red Rising. Yeah, I thought that's what you were doing.
No.
I finished the first one, by the way. I finished... The first one is Red Rising, right?
Yeah. Yes. Oh, yeah,
I'm on a Golden Sun now.
You're in Golden Sun. So you're listening to Golden Sun reading. He also
finished
reading
the Reckoners and listening to the Red Rising trilogy.
Okay. Yes. That makes sense.
Because in theory, it's fun to do like two things at once a little bit. Two stories. Can you do that? I guess that's a bad question because you don't listen to fiction.
No, I don't listen to fiction.
Auditorily, but say you did, would that be something you could do?
Like, read a book, but then listen to a different book? Yes, probably.
I think it's kind of cool. I get, like, double the fantasy for...
Yeah, I probably could. It's one of the main reasons why I don't listen to fiction, though. Is because of... Because I hate listening to fiction, as you know.
It's so good.
It is
so
well done.
It's terrible.
It's not.
I'm going for the red. I don't care.
Go more. Do whatever you want, Mikey.
I'm making bloody. Just make him bloody.
Again,
this is something that I appreciate, is that I know... So little.
I have no rules.
Okay, I'm gonna go with Golemin Flesh for skin tone.
Nobody knows it. Nobody knows it.
Sorry.
It's gonna happen a lot.
I don't know if this guy's just muscled or scarred or what, but he's got a lot of texture.
I like the red.
I know. I mean, I might have to like try to find a way to matte this out later if it doesn't dry very matte, but we'll see.
They will dry matte-ish.
I'm having fun. I don't want to.
I don't necessarily want to make him look skinless.
Yeah, see, he
like
might
just his
he might end
showing.
Up looking like he's got mostly just muscle showing, which is kind of creepy and weird, but also I like it.
We'll see. I might, yeah, well.
I want to give him more of a real look, but, you know. Yeah, folks, we'll be here for a bit. We'll be here basically for 2 hours if my laptop battery lasts. It probably won't. So basically until my laptop battery dies. But thank you all for being here. This is awesome. I know it's early for anyone on the West Coast, but we wanted to keep streaming for Gen Con and stuff, and we were able to because of Draughts London here, which is just the coolest. So
yeah, it's a cool spot.
Yeah, this spot is. We're going to stick around here and play
like I love and
play some games, probably.
Yeah, for sure. I love like industrial
yes
vibes. Like this is the type of place that if I were to do something, like, I would hope to build something. That's a train there.
Train's coming over.
Train's coming down. Yeah.
So this man has got spikies all over his skinsies. But yeah, we'll probably pick and hang out. We're gonna try and I hope they have a cribbage board here. We want to try and play some cribbage today.
Yeah.
Our grandmother unfortunately passed away last night, so we want to play a little bit of cribbage in honor of her.
Her and Grandpa, man.
So if you got them, drop bing bongs and chat for Grandma Inga.
It's our last grandparent.
That's I know, and that sucked.
Yeah. But you know what? She lived a damn good life. A good long one. You can't really have any complaints. This guy looks like he's just skinless. Maybe I should lean into it.
Here's the thing, though. Like, maybe put something on over it. I don't know. Like, we want to...
It's terrifying.
He looks gross.
He looks...
Gnarly. He looks gnarly. But, so what you've been doing slash playing? We've been playing a lot of like little roll rights. We actually only played two games on the plane.
It was
the plane was
the plane ride went quick, did it not? To me, it felt very fast.
I was talking to Paul about it. It felt shorter than a lot of times when we're flying just across the East Coast. It felt
maybe because it was exciting because we're you know we're
maybe,
going to
yeah.
play. But I was like, that was the quickest flight
of my life.
We also got very lucky. Virgin, I guess, got in trouble. Not in trouble. People were complaining. So. Virgin, on the day that we flew, people aren't traveling as much right now, obviously. And our plane was like half empty.
Yeah.
And like, it's not peak travel season as well, but like that had to have factored in. And so we all had like tons of space. Like Nick, Paul and I were in a row together, and in the section of the plane we were in, there's, you know, the side, a middle
a big
row,
old
and then
plane,
the
yeah.
side, the entire middle. Empty. All of it was empty.
Literally all of it.
So they said, like, right away, like, just spread out. Take your own row if you want. So we did, and we had all this space. And so I think there was, like, a comfort level there that helped.
Oh,
but it
great.
Went so fast. We,
it
like,
did.
Literally played a game. We played Villages of Valeria,
which
is
really
fun.
Fun
little
really
kind of engine builder type thing. It's quick. We played that, and then we were hanging out chatting. And then we all kind of, like, settled in to sort of rest and relax. I watched a couple movies. We played... Patchwork Doodle, and then like the flight was over.
Yeah,
immediately. It was wild.
Yeah, I played Luigi's Mansion, which is great.
Oh, you were playing that?
Yeah, I played it for a couple hours. It's super fun,
isn't it?
I love the little secrets. I love. Yeah, it's. I really like Luigi's Mansion a lot. And yeah, I played a little Civ 6. Talked with Paula a lot, you know, and just like it was incredibly fun. So we played those on there. We didn't play very much yesterday. We were mostly just trying to stay alive yesterday because we were so tired.
We did play Sushi
did
Roll,
play
and we played Silver and Gold again.
Silver and Gold again, and Sushi Roll is great. Went out to the wonderful Japanese restaurant yesterday and just hung out with Matthew. We planned on playing more games last night. We ended up just talking for 2 hours.
We're all
great.
Kind of pooped, and it was just nice to... Oh, he's drying out nice. Okay, that's more the color I was actually going for. This is perfect.
Well, yeah, he's all shiny because it's wet.
Yeah, that's what I was like, I hope this mats out. But yeah, we just ended up chit-chatting. I mean, it's been nice to spend time, you know, and like we'll definitely be playing some games. I mean, obviously all weekend we'll be playing games, so we'll get that there. And there'll be some quieter days the next couple days before aircon starts, get hyped. So we'll probably play some stuff. And then on that, it's like we're gonna be doing a lot of walking around and stuff.
Yeah,
like,
we went to see kind of some touristy stuff today.
Yeah, as always with these trips, it's like, and conventions for that matter, it's like you never play as many games as you think you're gonna do.
No.
You know, it's just like.
I thought the entire plane ride was gonna be nonstop games. We played two. And then at one point, me and Paul were like, you want to play a game? Both of us kind of like, nah, I'm down to just hang out and chat. So it was just like, all right. Like, it was very odd.
I imagine maybe on the plane ride back, we'll play some more stuff.
Yes. But we had this like little RPG that we were going to play. That would have taken like 2 or 3 hours of the trip, maybe even more. And we ended up not playing any of that.
I didn't do any work on it to get ready.
Yeah.
It's fine. It's fine.
Did you really?
Well, I had to learn it and everything.
Oh, well, I'm sure we'll play it. We'll play it at some point.
It's not like a typical DM situation where I have to create stuff.
So. Yeah, yeah.
No, it's just give me a poop.
And thank you for all the bing bongs in chat.
Shout out to Grandma, dude. We toasted her this morning.
Yeah, she's...
It was a bummer of a text to wake up to and stuff, but like,
yeah.
It's honestly the best. She was 93, like survived World War II, immigrated to America, created and lived through the American dream. Like literally created her own business with her husband, like every sort of like marker of the traditional marker of like this is a good life, right?
Yeah.
Not that those should really exist and stuff, but like she did that. So I'm like, dude, you know what?
She had a great life. And we almost lost her 2 years ago. We literally said goodbye.
Yeah.
And then she ended up pulling out and lived another 2 years. So it's like we got so much more time with her than we were expecting. That now it's like it's still very, very sad, of course. But it's like, we're just so happy that we got that time. Yeah. That we're kind of like, I'm not even that... I'm not even that sad. I'm like, no, I'm not sad. But, you know, it's hard to explain, but I think other people can understand.
I mean, Nick did grin and then cackle this morning, which was a weird reaction.
It was very odd. Immigrated from Germany, from Norway.
Norway, yeah, Norwegian. But, like, literally, like, survived and escaped, like, hid Grandpa up in a farm in the north of Norway so that he didn't get recruited into the Nazi army.
Into
like,
the German army, yeah.
You know, like, just craziness, you know? Like, just... That was one thing that I loved to kind of, like, pick our grandparents' brain about. And I obviously wish... You could always wish you could do this more, but, like, to think you're 93, but 93 in the time that Grandma's... Like, she predates like TV, predates like radio being readily available in houses, like all these things.
She watched the space race. Cars, really, for the most part.
Yes, I mean, the internet blowing it, like all these things. I'm like, that is
like living from 1900 to 2000 is a crazy time to live in. Like that is so much has changed. Not that a lot didn't change before, but like if you're like, you know, 1510. To 1610, stuff changed for sure, but not like, you know, ever since the Industrial Revolution, things have been so different.
It all changes so quickly.
You know, and it's like, she saw some stuff.
Yeah, it's just like, whoa.
Fuzzy so Logic said, my first con is in 9 months. I am pumped for you.
Rad. Do we know, you may have mentioned, which convention would that be?
I'm not sure. Essen probably? Because Fuzzy Logic's this side.
No, that won't be 9 months. That'd be December. PAX? You going to PAX and plug?
Can Mom said, hi, dropping in for a few minutes before I go to work. Hi.
Who is it?
Can Mom.
Hey.
What it do?
No, no apology necessary, Birdman.
The birdie of all men.
It's okay if people do not know or remember where our grandparents immigrated.
Are from.
That is acceptable. So is this that brownie you're using?
I think so, yes. It was right here?
No, it was right here. This is the one you said was too dark. Right?
This is the one I was using. This is this.
That's, which is what? I'm sorry.
This is this.
Okay, because I want something darker. I'm going to do the little wrappies around his legs and stuff.
Yeah, that's fine.
I want a darker. Maybe I'll even go darker.
I'm using a slightly darker red than Mike used for the skin for the helmet here. It might be too dark. But we're in it. We're in it right now.
Oh, Fuzzy said, I was at UK 9 months ago. Aircon is next. Copy. So 9 months ago was your first one.
Oh, okay.
Only 9 months from now.
I was like, you're this side. I was like, I know you're this side of the pond.
Cool. I was confused. My bad. Misunderstood.
It's tough because it's Fuzzy Logic and Fuzzy Foot. We got two fuzzies with us. Fuzzy Foot, we saw at Dice Tower West.
Everyone's so fuzzy.
Everyone's so fuzzy.
Everyone here is so fuzzy. I love it.
Michael, we're doing so good. Thank you so much, brother. We appreciate you.
Great service at Drafts.
Really incredible. Michael over there is great, man. Really great.
No one's paying us to say that. They're just generally cool.
Yeah, Draughts London is awesome. Yeah, there's cool two here and then Hackney. Come on, say Harrogate. I'm like, no, Harrogate's a different city.
Much different.
That's where we're going to be.
Birdman says, yeah, I get that about picking their brains. Y'all know I'm a huge Packer fan, American football for our European folk. And I didn't find out that they were at the Ice Bowl, one of the most famous NFL games ever, until after they passed, which had some time back. I think we all do that.
We all do.
And it's okay. But I think we all, like, when people are gone, you're like, man, I wish I'd asked all these questions, or I wish I had taken time to
or just
like, ask about their story. And so it's a good reminder of, like, do that with your parents.
Yeah,
while
that's
you
really
have them, if you have them. Do that with friends, and just, you know, it's a good reminder and stuff, but it's always, yeah, easy to beat yourself up, like, oh, I wish I had known this and this and this, and
well,
just
for
be,
me,
be
it's
grateful,
like,
for what you did get.
It, not that I'm not saying, like, oh, I wish I had more time. I'm just like, man, I wish I was an adult when these people, because when you're a kid, you just don't, like, even if they were telling you stories about, like, their childhood, not that you were,
you don't appreciate,
you, just, you weren't that interested because you were just, you didn't understand the, what they were saying.
Yeah.
You didn't understand, like, what that means.
Yeah.
All, you're just kind of like, hey, you, I like you. You're my grandparent.
We,
like,
kind of
you're
found
a dumb
out
kid.
More about, and, like, my grandpa, like, wrote a book about, like, their family history and stuff.
Yeah.
So we actually should read that, reread that. But, like, as a kid, it's like time and what's going on in the world, it's just, your world is so much smaller, so you don't get it. But now, like, hearing their story and knowing that, like, they made it through World War II and all these different things, I'm like, that, it, it just becomes, you, like, you can appreciate
every
scope
it, yeah,
of it all more, and you're like, whoa, you know, it's just so cool.
You're
so,
like, holy.
Yeah, it's tricky when you're a kid, because your world is just,
your life
is
was
much
nuts.
More limited and self-focused,
yeah,
as it,
and that's
ought to
okay,
be.
But it's just, like, that's been so much of it. It's like, I love going, like, I love going to, like, the holidays now, not so much because of the stuff I'm getting, which used to be my main thing when I was a kid. Like, oh, presents!
Sure.
But now it's like, I can, like, getting to, like, talk to your aunts and uncles or whatever as an adult is so much better because, like,
a peer,
you can,
yeah,
talk to them, yeah, more or less as a peer. And it's just huge. What's up, Miramek? How you doing, Miramek? We're in London.
We're in
it
London.
Right.
Happy early morning to you,
hello,
in Los,
hello,
Angeles.
Hello. What the heck time is it there? It is 2?
It's, no, it's 1.
1:30.
1:33?
A.M.
And
this place is raging.
Now,
P.M. 1:30 P.M. indeed. Yeah, we are here
crazy
at Draughts London, which we tweeted about. If GenCon can retweet, it gives them some stuff. They're a super cool little game store here, a little game cafe in London, underneath a train tunnel. It's in a train tunnel. It's really cool. It's really, really cool. And they're lucky enough to have us. They were nice enough to let us stream here.
I love that. Like, we all misspeak, right? It's part of human existence. When you
sometimes
misspeak in a way that makes you sound incredibly arrogant. They're lucky enough to have us here today. And they're like, what? Like, you paid to be here. Oh, yeah, okay. You know, you're just a regular customer who's taking up more space than probably we should.
We're only on one table.
Nah, I know. They were actually really cool. They're like, you need, like, a huge table.
Yeah,
they're
like,
no,
you know, for live streams, for painting, you need a lot of space. Do you need,
yeah,
multiple tables? Like, no, one table's,
like,
fine.
Yeah, that's awesome. We're like, oh, we just,
like,
we
only got
be,
one camera in our,
yeah,
laptop.
We want to be as little nuisance to you as possible.
Yeah, we're just like, dude, what can we
so
do?
So you don't regret having us. Yeah.
Yeah, they were super nice.
Ask them if they want to do a pop-up Gen Con. They are.
Do you actually want to ask?
Because
we will.
Pop-up Gen Con would be rad over here. I mean, I'm saying, Miramek, you gotta get Gen Con in the Briton.
Gen Con in the Briton.
You know, it'd be pretty sweet.
There's your first flyer right there.
TM, you gotta pay. You want that sweet flyer, you gotta pay.
But yeah, so I'm just painting off screen. So yeah, so we're painting here, you know, we're like, we gotta keep making these Gen Con streams work
as much as we can, and it's fun. Like, I actually genuinely enjoy, like, trying to find
make it
ways
work
to,
yeah,
the, I think it's just,
I think it's fun.
It's a different thing, and, like,
I totally
it's not
agree.
Ideal circumstances in terms of, you can't control the
sound
environment
and,
as much,
yeah,
but I think it's also, like, that lends itself to the funness of it. Like, I always liked listening to, like, live versions of a podcast I like,
yeah,
as a
even
live
the
show.
Sound is way worse
because,
yeah,
it's just, like, you know, it's not even that much worse, it's just different, it's a different,
yeah,
atmosphere. It's just fun. I think it's cool. How am I going to get this guy's leg?
Try to be getting up in here.
Oh, yeah, I handed you that mini because, like, I'm not.
Yeah, Mike's like, oh, you paint this one. I was like, you suck.
And I was like, that seems very hard. I'm not going to do that. These are ones who I'm like, seems like it probably would be slightly easier if they're off their base.
Yes, these actually, looking back at them, I probably would not have based them. But we didn't, so. This is why a lot of times I pin them to cork instead. That way, if I need to take them off the cork, I can very easily. Because, yeah, there are some times you're getting up in here, you're like, man, their base, especially these bases are unnecessarily large. These ones they come on, I don't know why they come on this big. At least I think this is the one they come on. I don't know why they come on bases this big, but they do. So...
we stuck into these, but they came in the same pack, I imagine. Is that what you mean? Because, like, we glued these to these guys.
I don't remember, because I put all my bases in, like, little drawers in my mini handy thing.
Oh, so these could be, in theory, bases for some other
mini. I'm 90%
mini.
Sure these are the bases for this, but now putting them on, I'm like, these are large. But I think, because otherwise, I don't know why I have so many of these bases.
No, I'm sure it is. I'm sure it is for
this. Because these are the ones that... the Stormcast Eternal go on, and David bought other bases
it kinda
to
makes
put them
sense
on because he doesn't like how big these are.
It kind of makes sense that they'd be kind of big because like a lot of these people do have like
the lean. Like, yeah.
Leaning
I mean, look at this
moving.
Guy. This guy is leaning
yeah.
at
so you can't have some tiny thing or they'll be all wobbling.
To the point where I'm always very worried about their connection to the base. Yeah, it's always like a foot. Has the con started? No. We're heading up on... Friday is when it starts.
Yeah, so we're going up to Stourbridge tonight, which is where Matthew lives.
Today's Wednesday? Yeah, Thursday we'll go up.
And tomorrow we're going up to Harrogate, and then Friday the convention begins. Just a weekend con.
Yes, more corn. Yeah, it's very spontaneous. Yeah, this is fun. I like doing this. This is really great.
Just don't take the cork out of your fork.
Bam, bam. Boop, boop, boop. So this guy's coming. Honestly, I'm not gonna lie. This contrast paints are pretty darn cool. Because here's the thing, if you're just batch painting, this skin doesn't look bad.
No, like I was just thinking about that. Like you get like, obviously it kind of pools into the recesses like you like, but there's even kind of like variations
it's
and
like,
stuff.
It's really
so it looks,
not bad. Like,
no, it looks cool.
And this tried to kind of like batch exactly paint a ton, like why not? Or one thing that like a lot of people, I was reading this kind of article about these. And the guy was talking about, he likes contrast paints for his kids because they want to be able to paint their minis like dad. And with this, they can do it because it's easy for them to learn, you know? And so, So, for a quick little thing, it's not bad. It's not bad. Let's give this bad boy a shake. Let's make sure this is very on tight. There we go. But yeah.
So it's not tight. Excuse me. It will get everywhere because it is very thin.
Dude, I what was it? This one that's like a third full because
really
I spilled
does.
The entire thing on my mini painting table. Luckily, it was pretty easy to clean up, but I was like, God.
So I'm going to do...
See, that makes sense because it paints the highlights and lowlights for you a bit. Yeah, totally. For batch painting, quick stuff, or you don't care about your paint job that much, or, you know, again, you need to like... paint everything real quick. Again, because I get the whole thing is like, for these guys are just grunts. They're just your ground troops.
They're your elites.
You don't care that much. You're not for the big lieutenant dude or whatever. It's like, yeah, like, make that one big and crazy and cool. But it's like, these guys, it's like, it doesn't matter as much. I totally get it. Or if you're like, hey, I need to paint these by this weekend because I'm playing a game, do this.
Because, I mean, like, there's nothing wrong with, like, I just want to have them have some colors. I'm going to slap some paint on there, and, like, I don't particularly care about, like, I mean... You know, Nick and I have had this discussion. Granted, I'm very new to this. Nick hates base painting. He loves only doing highlighting and all that stuff. And for me, that's intimidating. It's tedious. I don't feel like I do it well, so it gets discouraging at times. So, like, something like this is awesome because you're like, I get to do the fun part and do it quick. And, like, there might be some people out there like, I don't need all the highlight and stuff.
No.
Like, I don't need to geek out on it on that level. So I just want to just get some color onto this thing.
Totally.
And so it is a really cool for just, like, get it splashy.
Yeah, as Miramek said, it's like you can't spend 12 hours on each grunt. You just can't. Like, it's... I mean, yeah, I guess you can, right? But it's like, you probably shouldn't.
If you're doing that, like, I would imagine you're taking that time because really the painting is the thing.
Yes, the painting is the fun for you.
About...
Which is,
using
it is for
them
me. Like, I paint minis because I like painting minis.
Yeah,
I don't
and you
really
take your time.
Care about...
Like, in general, you're a slow painter, you'd say.
Yes, oh, very, very slow.
So.
It's annoying how slow I am.
But you're also not necessarily in a rush because you actually really enjoy the artistic process.
Yes. Although, like, I have very, very been slowly collecting Tyranids for a long time, and I do have a lot of just, like, Hormigaunts and Termigaunts, which are, like, the grunts. And these, I'm like, and I've painted a couple, and they do take a while because they got a lot of little bits to them and stuff like that. And I'm like, oh, dude, I'm going to find a contrast color scheme that I like because it will literally take me, because I don't care about those guys very much.
You're trying to get to the big,
oh
cool.
Oh my, yeah, those ones, yeah. I'm gonna make those ones look freaking rad. But like the little Hormigons, I'm like, yo, this is like gonna be a game changer for me. I'll tell you right now, with painting my Tyranid army.
Yeah. Did you ever find a paint scheme you like? Because
nope.
Nick has been playing with this. You've done some
for years.
Like,
I still can't
purpley
decide.
To greener. That's more kind of what the Tyranids actually look like, don't they? They're kind of
Tyranids have like white skin and purple carapaces.
Yeah.
And
are
I actually
kind of
hate the GW contrast scheme. The GW not contrast. GW scheme for them. I think it's super boring. Because one thing I like about Tyranids, you can paint them whatever color you want. So I'm
like purple and green and stuff. Like you have
a couple of different things
that look really neat.
I can't
together.
Decide. I've done it. I've tried like five or six different times to like where I've painted a bunch of different Tyranids, all different colors. And I still can't decide. I don't know. I can't decide on a color scheme for them.
Yeah. Every time you look, I've seen like things done. They look super cool to me.
Yeah.
And I agree that like maybe not doing the white skin is a cool move, just because they're like.
No, yeah, I think
go for color.
Go
you know,
for
make
color.
It
well, I, and I don't mind like their bodies. Like that's like their bodies. You know, not their carapaces. I think you really
yeah.
should, and that's what their purple is on GW. But even then, I'm just like, they don't have to be just like white. Like it, I know it's just I always thought they were kind of boring looking.
Oh yeah, we're painting some Khorne demons today. Sorry, you asked that a couple minutes ago.
Indeed,
and thank you
I'm
for
sorry,
Merrimack. Appreciate you.
What was that?
I just finished my Mortine protein drink. That's Ripper. Getting all fired up for the day, hopefully. I finished my old Jamaica ginger beer.
Oh.
We had breakfast.
Oh, Marine Mike, you're on our
yeah,
phones
it's,
here.
It's,
your
I have dark
name
mode,
is in black,
so it's
and like
invisible.
I was like, Merrimack, who are you talking to? I'm sorry, Marine Mike.
Or
yes, we're painting Khorne demons.
Using a contrast paint.
So
set from,
I think I know for yes. Thank you, Mikey, for clarifying that. We are painting with contrast paints. Because they're the easiest for us to break.
Forgot to paint my fella's hands.
Dude, I did done that before.
I guess I could have made them gloves.
I know what I want my carapaces to be. I did it where I was like red and then orange and yellow. So they look kind of like fire, not like fire, but they have like a fire color scheme to them.
Ooh.
And I really like that, but I can't figure out what body color I want on them. Because I don't want
how much
the
skin
body
is showing versus carapace.
A lot.
Really?
Yes.
Okay.
It's mostly skin, because the carapaces are mostly just on their back.
Oh, okay.
The rest of them, the guys are like holding the guns. Like, all that's what's considered their body.
Okay.
So the thing is, like, I don't want like a really, really bright body with a really bright carapace. It's too much.
You don't
want
to take it away from the carapace, but you don't want it to be.
But I also don't want the body
sleepy.
To be boring.
Yeah.
So I might try like a blue.
That'd be kind of cool.
Yeah.
Get a little fire and ice vibe.
Yeah, you know.
Subtly.
So I don't know. Well, I can't decide. But now the contrast paints exist, because the carapaces I'll still paint normally.
Yeah.
Because I can't do the look I want, but like for the body, oh my gosh, it's going to be incredible. I need to get some of this contrast paint from Citadel they're using. Yeah, it's pretty nice. I mean, again, like.
They're pretty cool. I'm having fun painting with them.
Just as it is.
I've gotten a little bit better at them, because like they're not, it's not like night and day difference, but they're so much thinner. They work kind of like more like a wash, and so that has been a little bit of a, like, the first time we painted, I was like, oh, I maybe even thinned them out a little bit, and it was way too thin and stuff, so it's been, but now I'm kind of getting used to it, I'm like, oh yeah,
yeah.
They're pretty cool, man.
They're pretty darn cool.
I'm definitely seeing how they can be employed.
What English beverages have we had so far? Nothing really particularly English. I never had old Jamaica ginger beer, but nothing particularly English. We haven't had any tea. I tried Dr. Pepper Zero, which was just Diet Dr. Pepper. No, nothing particularly British. We had beans with our breakfast this morning.
Did have a British
because
breakfast.
Because that's a British thing.
I had beans and sausage and eggs for breakfast.
Mike, you had bangers.
Excuse me, bangers.
Bangers or sausages here. Yeah, nothing particularly British, unfortunately. I mean, I had fish and chips. That's pretty British.
That was the first thing we ate.
Marie Mike said, I normally pick different themes for the events I sign up for at Gen Con each year. For this year, I actually picked miniatures. Any recommendations on game systems for a beginner to try? I would say something like, and we both agree on this, I would say something like Zombicide.
Yes.
because there's a ton of miniatures for you to practice on, like a billion.
Super fun.
And two, they're zombies. So if they look kind of dirty or they look kind of crappy, it doesn't matter. They're supposed to look really haggard because they're zombies.
There is a, and there's a, yeah, you can get away with some errors.
And anything you don't like, cover with blood. If the eye didn't come out good or this hand, you actually touch the hand with a different color, cover with blood. You can cover up every single mistake with blood. Have a whole 1B blood. Like, yeah. This is just a blood one.
I'm missing, like, especially, like, washes really help because they make them look a little grungy.
Yes.
And it's perfect because they would be grungy. So, yeah. Like...
That's how I got started. It was Zombicide.
Yeah. Like, and when we started this a few weeks ago, and not that I'm an expert at all, but, like, we started with Rum and Bones because it was a similar thing. They're like water skeleton. Like, they'd be kind of grimy and stuff. So... You can throw some washes on. You can be a little bit wilder with that stuff. But, like, mainly it's, like, not blowing my anyone. Something that looks cool and dynamic, you know, because if you do that and you put a paint and wash on it, like, looks cooler because it's a cool mini.
Yeah. Oh, like, by the way, me going, like, I don't like that color. No, I wasn't saying that to you.
Yes.
You don't agree with my opinions?
No.
While you're doing it, I was in my head being like, I didn't like that color.
But also what you said was wrong. I don't know.
I'm going to do
any help at all.
Basilicanum gray for the pantaloons. Because I want to be dark, but I don't really want to use the black. I think I might try to do a couple different...
Remix says, that's a wonderful idea. Thank you. I've played Zombicide before and didn't really think about it as a miniature game, but more of a board game. I was thinking more like Warhammer as a game system. I don't know the right terminology.
Oh, in terms of that, Nick would be the expert. Warhammer. I mean, honestly, really,
Warhammer.
If you're looking for a specific game, that's the thing. If you're looking for a specific game, sure, Warhammer. The problem with Warhammer is you don't want to like practice on those minis because the minis could be like good. I would say if you're gonna do like something like Warhammer, start with something like the Stormcast Eternals because they're mostly just gold, which means you can throw gold paint, throw a wash on them, and they'll look pretty good. Honestly, if you're looking just to practice, I would say go get a bunch of Reaper Bones minis from like your local game store. They tend to be very, very cheap, especially if you get one of their Kickstarters. Like they send you like 100 miniatures, and they end up being like less than $1 each or something like that for like the whole thing. I would say do something like that if you're looking just to try to practice. The main thing I would say, start with very textured minis, something with like fur cloaks or something like that, because that is easier to... I'm trying to think how to put this. I'm not sounding like an ass. It can hide your amateurism, I guess is what I'm trying to say. It's like the fact that you're new, because a highly textured cloak, you just paint it, and then something like a wash that works really, really well on something very textured.
Like, one thing, like, if I can speak as the new person, I cannot paint like brush strokes with any consistency at all. Like if I needed to paint just like a square here and make it all look the same, there's no way. Nick could do something like that. He's done a lot of painting, marker work. He knows, like, so I'd be all over the place. And so if you're doing something big and smooth, it's going to show, you're going to see the work.
Yeah.
And texture, there's natural things. So, I did this brushstroke over here, and my brushstrokes might have been all over the place, but it kind of works out because the texture is changing the light that's hitting all these things anyhow.
Yeah.
So your brain is used to, everything's going to look different. So big and smooth, everything should look the same.
Yeah.
That's hard.
Yeah, I would say stay away from, like, big, smooth miniatures. He said, I'm the same with inconsistent brush strokes. Yeah. So I would say something textured, you don't really need that.
I haven't gone for anything smooth at all. Like, I'm just like, that's going to sound very hard.
Well, that's one thing I'm excited for is because we're doing these guys. These guys have these big... burly, muscly backs with that. Yeah. These are all smooth areas. You're going to have to start trying.
Yeah, and like with the contrast paints, like you can see that it didn't do so hot with it, but it kind of works out. It's looking okay, but it's hard.
Yeah, it's
something difficult. That I'm excited to get better at, but it's just...
And the thing is, it's just paint. You just got to paint. The way you get better is by painting more. Getting a specific kind of brush, a specific kind of paint, none of that will make you better. You just got to paint. You just got to do it, you know? But I would say start with something... textured or something that won't look bad if it looks kind of dirty or haggard or something like that, because it's a good way to hide mistakes.
Hide the moo-boos.
Or something that you can cover blood, because then you can hide whatever the heck you want.
That'd be awesome.
Gets crazy bloody.
Yeah.
Okay, we're doing okay. We're doing okay. Mirror Making isn't wrong. Gen Con's got a bunch of great mini painting classes and events this year and really any year. I mean, heck, we did one at PAX Unplugged last year. We did a mini painting class. That was very fun.
Very fun.
So I'm partial to Battletech role-playing games. Something with some kind of mech. Now, mechs are different because they tend to have a big flat area, but mechs you can make look really grungy. Like, we've been slowly painting Scythe, and I think after we're done painting some Khorne demons, we're going to be moving on to painting Scythe minis. And that'll be fun because of the fact that Scythe mechs, you kind of want them to be rusted and dirty and gross looking because they're mechs. You know, they're covered in oil and covered in da-da-da-da-da-da-da and all that kind of stuff. So you can really get away with something like that. I would say just pick minis that are going to give you the best chance of success.
Yeah, because it's like...
Or best chance something you're going to be proud
so much,
of.
And also don't worry so much about the results.
Yeah.
But it's cool if you have something that looks cool at the end, because I know for me, I'm like, that gets me fired up to do another one. You know, and... You
contrast, Wildwood.
I'm trying to find some for the pants.
Yeah, I did this gray. I don't love it. I might try and put some over it. I don't love it. You know what I do love, though? This ridiculously British mug that we bought specifically to wash paint water.
It's what every British person drinks their tea out of right here.
Yes. This exact mug. It's the national law. The Queen hath declared it so.
Look at you, Jack, on that tea. Yeah, maybe that'll work. We'll find out. I might have to do a couple layers.
You're not wrong, Mike.
I might have to do a couple layers.
So I'm trying to decide if I want to brush some of this gray. You got the Wildwood. How dark is that?
It's this one. That's pretty dark. What are you trying to paint?
I kind of want to put a pseudo wash on my red stuff to kind of deepen the but I don't really want the rest of it, so I'm trying to think if there's something I can kind of brush into the... I'll use this one, Cycor. Kind of brush into the...
I see.
Shadowed areas.
I see you.
So, they are live from Draughts, a board game cafe in London. You just heard a train going by. This train's right above us here.
Yes, you
see
did.
This brick wall? This is because we're in a tunnel.
Yes, you did.
It's awesome.
It is very cool, very fun.
But yeah, so thank you all for being here. This is awesome. I know it's early for a lot of people. We are on earlier. And thank you, Gen Con, for being cool with the fact that our schedule's super weird right now. But
what an adventurous life we live, man.
It's very weird, and I love it.
We're very lucky, man.
Freaking love it. This was a mistake.
I made a mistake.
This was a bad idea. Wow. That's dumb. That's way too dark. This isn't working.
Even Nick makes boo-boos.
Oh, man. I just ruined it. Well, we're going with it.
Oh, it's pretty dark.
No, Michael, do not try.
I was trying.
Do not try.
I was going to help you out. And I looked at it and said, well, clearly, ooh. I just know what talking about.
Let's see if we can salvage this one.
Oh, you can salvage it, man. What's your rule, Nick? If it all goes to Hades, what can you always do?
You can strip the paint dragon.
Ew.
Or just paint over it. Yeah.
Contrast paint's a little harder to paint over it.
Contrast paint a little harder to paint
over
it.
Always strip it and do
it again.
Although
I will be doing another layer of red on that to try to get rid of that.
So, hey, you're never out of the woods.
You're
never not able to get out of the woods, the way I meant. But you're also never out of the woods. You're always sort of a little bit in danger at all times.
Here's the thing, man. You're never out of the woods. We'll try to do this snake bite leather for the kind of the wraps on the back of his shin things. Yeah.
Yeah, I think I'm digging the pants. I think I'm digging it. I think I'm gonna like that just fine.
Oh, that's nice. Yeah, that's nice. Yeah, nice dark brown.
I think it's gonna be all right. The wildwood, the contrast wildwood, is doing it.
Very cool.
He's got a little pant tassel. Same pants, same color as the pants. Show the difference. I'm going to go back and do some extra boot work here because I was a little sloppy Joe's and missed,
all right.
Missed some stuff.
A little sloppy Joe over here, but yeah, it's okay.
What are you going to do? Joe's just a sloppy fella.
Yeah, why is Joe so sloppy? That's the real question.
His mom asks him that all the time. Say, go clean your room. I don't know why you're so sloppy, Joe. He said, I can make a food based on my life.
I'm going to be a millionaire.
I'm going to sell at every elementary school on earth.
Like, why at elementary schools they serve literally the messiest meal?
The thing is, it's funny, is like, I used to like, oh, sloppy Joe, but like, it would happen like once a year, but it's like built up to be like this like
constant
thing. Yeah. And I think it's because in cinema it is, because it's,
I guess it's a good point. Yeah, it's like, really not that
interesting
common.
Looking for, you know, it's, it, but yeah, I always wonder, like, how prevalent is it? Did anyone have sloppy Joes in school?
Like, no, often. Not like the occasional once a year.
Yeah, was it like a, one of the standard meals? Because I'd be very curious.
Because we had them at home more than we had them at school.
Yeah.
Mom would make us sloppy Joes.
Yeah, once in a while we'd have sloppy Joes at home. I love it. I still love it. Sloppy Joes are delicious.
They are good.
It's just hamburger meat with like whatever
kinda
that sauce.
Sweet,
whatever
sweet, yeah, sweet. It's like a sweet kind of sauce. It's really good.
Ketchup-y-ish, sort of. It's weird. It's its own deal.
Okay. So I want to do this basilicatum gray right here for the fur on the trim, and I need to touch up some of the pants. Man, witch. I guess man witch, yeah. Man witch is like a sloppy Joe thing, isn't it?
Yeah.
People must be
it's
so
great
confused.
For deer meat. No way. Did you do a venison man witch?
I eat it.
I eat it, but I just never, would never think of it. But I also just don't think of deer meat in general. Tend to forget about it.
I do love this one, deer meat.
Alrighty.
Boom. Gonna touch up these pants down here because I didn't actually paint anything on them.
Oh god.
So my guess is we got probably like 20, maybe 30 minutes left. Basically, we're going to go until my computer battery runs out. Because I don't have a way to plug it in.
Mid-sentence we go silent, you know what happened.
We'll try and count it before it dies. But yeah. Basically.
So Merrimack says, yeah, the man which takes the gaminess out of it. I have a lot of in-laws in West Virginia. Interesting.
West Virginia, Mountain Mama.
I'd eat it. I'd eat it. I'd try it. Why not? Absolutely.
Yeah. Wait, I think I can picture it.
Yeah.
Yeah. That was the idea. I'm going to kill this deer and stuff in some manwich.
Throw in some hamburger helper,
sauce,
you know?
This stuff is good. So
it
it's
is.
Like, it probably would go with most meats.
Most things, yeah.
Here, may hit you with the country roads. Respect.
Country roads.
That's one of my favorite, like, memes and stuff. It's just like, some sort of, you know, cat is like, I'm not gonna drink tonight, and then it's just like has a cat like with the mount of the his cat has like West Virginia. At some point, just hammered and singing that song.
Mountain Mama.
Black Templar. I'm gonna do some Black Templar boots.
Okay, Black Templar is great.
Yeah, I might see this contra gore grunta fur for the little furry bits on the thing. Okay. It's called fur. I want it to look like fur.
There you go.
I've like
I'm doing
kept
a
like, no, I'm gonna do something else for this color, and it's like the tiniest little bit of this mini is just these. So it's like I should just whatever color is fine. I can do a blue if I want. It's a very small part of it.
Just doing a bit of this skeleton horde on the horns everywhere. I don't like this that much, honestly. It's more yellow than I would wanted it, but that's okay.
The skull?
Yeah.
I think it looks cool. You know what?
I'm sorry. It's just more yellow. I'd want it to be more straight brown.
It's good to me. Corn Demons just collect skulls, man. They all have just skulls on them.
They do. That's pretty common in Shindel and Games Workshop. There's always skulls everywhere. See, I mean, about like conscious paint, you can't. I actually touched the horn with this red, and that's red now. There's no way that's not red.
Yeah. Since it's there, it's kind of always there a little bit. Because they're so thin, you can't really, like, truly cover stuff up. Yeah, that's almost the exact same color. I don't know.
It doesn't matter.
Don't you crock, mama, take me home.
Oh. There's a group over here who's having a blast. I don't know what they're playing.
They just love it.
They got some wine and they're getting it. It's Wednesday. It's 2 p.m.
They must be on holiday like us, man. Just enjoying their life.
Yeah, feel free, as Mirvik said, anyone out there, to ask any mini-penny questions or just questions about whatever, gaming-wise or London or what we're doing or whatever. Anyone in chat other than Fuzzy Logic going to be at a...
AirCon.
Thank you. I almost said GenCon because we're on GenCon. But it's not quite right. Where do I want to... Snake bite lever. There it is. I need to do it.
Party time!
Hell yeah.
Need it party time.
Always.
Excellent.
Yeah, they're getting it over there.
It's like an older couple in the group. They're just like getting it. I love it.
They're playing, like Tripoli or something. Love it. That's why I like it. I just love these types of places because people come and get down.
There's like a cute couple here. They play the Connect Four and like one other thing and they just bounce out. And I'm just like, that's why these plays are great.
So fun.
You ain't got to play some big heavy thing. You ain't playing Antiquity. You know?
Merrimack says, I hope everyone will be at Gen Con. Everyone flipping better be.
I'll be there. Whether or not you want me to be there.
And we're going to be up in there. We're going to tear that place apart. It's not really a painting stream, so you make Merrimack just a little bit worried about something you've said.
We make Merrimack question Gen Con's affiliation with us every single time. Yeah. But not because of anything like serious, like we said something super like bigoted or anything like that. It's always just like...
It's always for absurd things.
Like, man, are they just too lit?
Are they too wild?
Are they too wild? That's the question.
They said that they're just going to randomly fist fight people in the hall. Like, they're going to challenge them to like a blood sport and like give them like gloves. And I'm like, That's weird.
Hey man, we had the blast zone with Mountain Dew sponsoring Gen Con.
Well, that is happening.
They will keep us around for those kinds of suggestions.
Yeah, for every 10 ideas, one of them pops out and you're like, that is actually decent.
Yeah.
Also still no, but that's not bad. You're on the right track. So
that is cool, Marie Mike. I'm glad you're gonna be at Gen Con painting some minis.
That's fantastic.
We are going
to
paint.
So you mentioned you try to do themes and stuff and with each year. What are some like kind of focuses you've had in years past? Like you're doing like minis and things this year. What are some areas you've kind of tried to like focus on before? Because I like that idea. I think that's
great.
It's, there's like with the Gen Con, for example, there's so many things going on. Everywhere at all times, you obviously can't do it all, and it's kind of like, where do you begin? So I kind of like the idea of like, well, I'm going to focus only on these types of things this year, because like that seems like a good way to pare it down to actually be able to execute sort of a schedule. So
what was that turquoise I had earlier? No, it was like a really dark, because that was when I was going to paint. He's not. Oh, here it is. I'm gonna paint his like little sash thingy. I have a dark turquoise. Cause why not?
I like that.
Maybe
I'll match you in that. Make ours twins.
Remember I said I basically pick a gaming system and go nuts.
Okay.
I love it. That's awesome. That's a good way to do Gen Con because again, like people always say, like, what do I need to see at Gen Con? We're like, nothing. Just see whatever seems interesting. Like, we don't mean there's nothing to see at Gen Con. There's too much to see at Gen Con because it's so huge. So we're just like...
It's like, where do you begin?
Don't worry about, like, what did I not get to see? It's like, don't worry about that. Just like, see what you can.
Like, you could literally just walk around
and do nothing.
Pop into rooms or panels. You could go into any space anywhere and there'll be something cool going on.
Yeah.
So it's like... we spend a lot of time just wandering, cruising around, seeing what people are doing. I just like to people watch people playing games and having a blast, you know?
Yeah.
Like, it's... Yeah, 100%. They got it all.
And that's the thing.
So
I'm always just like...
Mountain Dew Blast Zone and get blasted.
Like, if you're walking by something, you go, oh, that seems interesting, go do that. Don't worry about the things you're not getting to see. Just worry about the things that you want to see.
Enjoy the things that you are seeing if you're doing that, you know? Or, like, focus up and get a schedule and, like, have just focus on certain types of things in this and have that. I mean, there's no one right or way wrong.
No. I know people who do... Even just like from our followers or people that we know, way they do Gen Con is so, so different. We have like followers and friends who like, they're all about buying. They're the ones not running because no one runs, but you know, like speed walking as fast
as they
can.
They have a list of stuff they want to get. They want to get those things. And then they kind of do that and then they just go and hang out in their hotel and play their games with people.
And other ones, it's like they're just demos. They're just there to demo. Also, other times, it's events. It's going to see like the Critical Role thing or whatever. It's like, it just depends on what you want to do. For me, like honestly, my favorite thing in cons is just walking around. That's what I like to do. Like if we didn't go to Gen Con as an exhibitor, I would probably go and just walk around. That's all. And maybe see an event or two, but like I would just walk around. I like walking around conventions. That's like my favorite thing to do.
Yeah.
And that seems maybe boring to some people or like, what's the point? But I don't know. For me, like the funnest thing
fun
is
to
just
wander.
Is just walking around. That's all I really want to do.
Hmm.
Wander around, maybe buy something, but probably not. Just I've always just loved wandering.
Yeah, you are a wanderer. Skeleton horde. Did you use a skeleton horde for the skeleton?
Not all those that wander are lost. No, all that glitters is gone.
Oh yes, I do.
I keep doing that accent. I keep doing that accent, and we're in Britain, and it's. I've gotten dirty looks multiple times already. I can't help it. It's my go-to, and I'm around it always. Let it be.
Fuzzy Logic says at UK last year, UK Games Expo last year, I booked tickets to all the shows, and then the Star Realms tournament took 11 hours and I missed all but one show.
Wow, that is intense.
You must have done well in the tournament for it to be 11 hours.
That is intense. That is crazy.
Wow, holy crap.
Interesting. Hi, Dutch Yoda Dutch. I am so bummed out we're not going to get to see you, Rubra. That is mega bumtacular, sir.
I missed that news.
Yeah, because coronavirus, unfortunately. His work said, it's a little too risky. A little too risky. And we're like,
I mean, that's a bummer. But yeah. Rain check? Yeah?
Yeah, definitely rain check. We're going to see you at some point, bro. All right, so you got a kind of turquoise scent. It doesn't really work with the color scheme, but I like it because it just breaks things up. My only problem is it kind of draws your eye. I don't really want you looking at his butt, but that's where it's looking right now.
That's where we're looking, huh?
That's where we're looking right now.
I'm trying to think of, like, so I've got this belt, and I've got, like, little accoutrement on the belt and stuff. I'm wondering what to do with all that.
I've just been doing, for stuff like that, I've been doing snake bite leather.
Okay.
Just because, like, there's little buckles and stuff, and I'm like, eh.
Yeah.
Again, this is the problem with contrast paint. Like,
I just want to make it slightly different than, like, this
handle,
but it's
also...
It's
hard to do really small detail work. Contrast paint is not your jam. Like, that's not what it's meant for. So, like, I just been kind of like, eh, don't worry about the small detail stuff.
Snake bite leather is always a good choice, Merrimack. Doesn't it sound like a good choice?
It does. Snake bite leather.
Snake bit you, but I got its skin and turned into a leather.
Oh my.
That says definitely rain check. Somehow I need to stop buying games and come to the US.
Hey.
Something like that. And or slash, we'll just come to Europe as many times as we can and make it work that way. One way or another, we'll make it happen. How about that? We both agree to try to do our best.
Yes.
But like if there's great games, like don't not get great games. Get those great games. Come to Gen Con, Dutch, you know what I'm saying?
That's the real answer. Let it be.
What a great song, Nick. Would you agree this is a fantastic song?
Eh, it's okay.
Would you agree that the artists who made it at least are some of the best of all time?
Eh, they're okay. I would say they're overrated. and make both you and Matthew Jude very upset.
And that's why you do it, and I know you're trolling, but it's just so upsetting.
Well, no, I legit believe that.
But it's so upsetting that you know you're incredibly wrong.
I know I'm incredibly in the minority. Which may mean I'm wrong.
No, it's art. Isn't it not subjective? It's not in this case. Because it's the Beatles, but, you know.
So the only restoration games come to Spiel this year. We're probably going to Spiel this year. It's not guaranteed, but we'll probably be at Essen this year if you're going to be there.
We're hoping to
but
be.
But not with restoration. Because, as you said, they're not going.
Let it burn.
All right.
So it's Essen. Someday I'll go. Yeah, that's how we're looking at it. We're hoping it can be this year, but there's no...
Someday.
Not for sure, so...
Oh, well then, Dutch, we'll probably see you there. Again, it's not guaranteed that we will be going, but we're pretty sure we'll end up there. I'm very curious. Definitely a hope, for sure. If not a guarantee, it's definitely a hope.
What song is playing Merrick? It was Let It Be, and this is that...
Picture me rolling.
Yeah. So I lost, like, I was about to start singing and I lost the chorus.
How was your birthday, Dutch?
Yeah, how are all the pies?
Everyone drop happy birthdays in the chat for Dutch.
Yeah. And this boy had that. Did you have like a pie eating contest? You were making all the pies.
I'm not being on stream. I'm sorry, everybody. So next year, if we come here, right, we got to make this a whole thing. We'll shut down this place for a day.
Oh, dude, that's what's up.
Stream everything for GenCon.
Well, I'm actually very proud. Like, I recognize right at the last second there's a strap going down the skull, and now I paint the skull. It looks pretty cool.
All right.
Go me. I did it.
I did it. All righty. This is going well. We're just pumped we're here, everybody. We're just so excited. We just fully assumed. They're like, yeah, this may not happen. Like,
oh, wait.
You know, got to make sure that
it happened.
They're cool with us streaming here, and then the internet like wasn't working for us like 10 minutes before the stream, so we're like, well.
Yeah, a little snafu just
had
to
here comes a little cancellation, and it didn't happen, so that's nice. As far as I can tell, the
seems like it's been
we haven't really been dropping any frames or anything like that.
Yeah, thanks for hanging in with us, folks, and stuff. Any more word on going to Dice Tower Con East? The word is... We're not going to be there.
That is the word. The word is pretty darn official.
Yeah.
And that word is that we're not going.
Yeah. It's just,
and we won't speak for everyone, but we're pretty sure no one from this game is broken is going.
Yeah. There's just a lot going on this year. A lot of travel and stuff, and like with the puppies and things for me. I was the first one. I was.
Yeah, you were
always
like, nope.
I was like, hey, if people want to go, like, that's rad. I hope you do. But I was like, I can't do it. Because we have Origins, we have Gen Con, we'll be at BGG Spring. It's just one too many things.
Yeah, it's a lot during the summer. I mean, this marks the end of our, like, the beginning of our year, because the beginning of our year was absolutely insane, as all of you knew.
It
and the
was
summer is very similar to this. Maybe not quite so packed together, but very similar. And taking something out in the middle of it is...
It makes it much, like, it's weird to think of, like,
it
it's just one trip, but, like, it means that we'll have, like, BGG Spring, and then like 3 weeks, and then Origins, and then like a month and a half.
Whereas
then,
usually it's like 2 week
Gen
intervals.
Con versus just like boom, 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 you know?
Yeah, that's going to make stuff go. You said that's hella far and expensive to go Dice Tower East. And that's the thing also. It's like, yeah, it's like we're going to have to fly out to Florida during 4th of July week, which means it's more expensive than normal. And it's an expense that we, not only the time, it's an, oops, sorry. it's an expense we just can't really justify, at least this year, maybe next year, hopefully next year, you know? But we just can't justify
it. I imagine that's what it's going to be, is like next year, like we could do it every other year or whatever, but...
That's the hope, you know?
Yeah. Because I'm curious, I want to see the new location. I hope it goes super well over there and stuff.
Yeah, I'm pulling for it, of course. I'm gonna do another lay of gray. I want to darken it down a bit.
Gray day.
Yeah, Dr. Dave, my dad's on East Bummer for you all. Yeah, it's a bummer. But again, we're probably gonna go to Essen, so we'll get to see Dave at that point. You know, and we are getting to see Matthew here too. And Matthew comes during the summer anyway, so like, yeah, it just didn't make sense. It just didn't make sense this year, unfortunately. But hopefully in the future, you know.
Yeah.
It's to the point now, you know, we've talked about this a couple times now during the year where, you know, there's been offers for us to come to this or to that or whatever. And we're like, man, we're to the point now where we really just have to start choosing what we're doing and what we're not doing because we can't do it all anymore. Because it used to be where there's less things that we kind of wanted to go to or were offered to go to or whatever. And so it wasn't too bad, but now it's like we just have to choose. And that means, unfortunately, when you choose, that means one of those things ain't going to happen, which is going to be bummer for us, bummer for some other people, you know. And that's just...
Beer mixes, you also fancy, you get to choose. It is a very lucky, privileged position to be in to have to do that, but it's a bummer because, like, ideally we do everything all the time, but that's just not how life works. Like, you have to work and stuff?
Yeah, we are in a very privileged position for sure.
Super lucky to be able to do as much as we get to, it's for sure. I don't know what to do with this thing now with the sash.
I don't know. Pick something.
Missy says, haven't decided if I'll still go without y'all.
I hope you do. I mean, there'll be awesome,
so many other awesome people there, but that also makes sense. But yeah. Cool thing is, like, Dice Tower's a cool spot, so if you go, I'm sure it'll be fun.
Yeah.
And if you don't go, like, it will always be there next year. You know. Remax says, don't forget us when you get all famous. in theory, could grow and become famous, but ain't no way we're competing with Gen Con.
Yeah, we're not ever going to be bigger than Gen Con. Just throw that out there.
No, it just means we'll go to Gen Con more. We still go every year anyway. I don't know how we go to it more, but we'll find a way and do that.
We'll find a way. No, we ain't. We didn't.
Rift Charger Gray. I'm going to do Rift Charger Gray for that real quick. Let me keep it muted. Keep it chill.
There was a weird place where we got so big we start forgetting stuff and forgetting people. Jenk, I would have one up.
Ooh, Des says, I'll probably be demoing at the portal booth at Essen, so if you're coming, you're more than welcome at my table.
That's cool.
Sweet.
You think that's the Total Check Portal Games?
Yeah, man. You're going to get us all those Empires of the North expansions? I almost bought both of them on Amazon the other day. But then I was like, it will arrive while we're gone.
Yes.
I should not do that.
Yes, that's accurate.
But I really wanted to. It's like 20 or 25 bucks. Pretty cool.
I do want to try them. We were trying to try that Dice Tower West. Didn't happen.
It's basically priority number one this weekend for me.
Oh, yeah, because we're having a con. Yeah, probably sure.
We're going to a game convention.
I'm curious if you'll still be complaining about LA traffic after you experience Essen on Saturday.
Yeah, we will. I'm sure. I do know that it gets pretty brutal. I understand it. This is more kind of blue.
Hi, train. There's a giant train going on above us. That's splashed my face. If you're wondering what the heck is that sound, that's a train.
Just a train. It's a huge train.
He's a human, baby, I know you. I'm so looking forward to y'all's coverage of this con. Be interesting to see the difference is, if any, in a Brit con. I'm very curious of that as well.
I know.
It's also not a big con. It's like, what, 3,000-4,000? Somewhere in there? It's not very
huge. It's on the smaller side, yeah. So I'm super excited for that exact same thing. Like, is there like a really different energy than just American cons in general? I have no idea.
Yeah, it's like, maybe. I don't know.
sound like that for a couple and let it cool in kind of throughout.
That's fair.
All going
a good, good tactic there, bro.
We're going to see. We're going to see how this dries and then maybe choose something to go over it because it's... the parts on the high ends are almost like unpainted still. So it's,
yeah, that color is super, super light.
Mandy is coming to AirCon, yeah.
She
so far
is.
As I understand, I haven't heard different
very, yeah,
as
far as I know.
Had to back out, unfortunately. But,
yeah.
Suzanne, that is. And yeah, but Mandy's still coming, so far as I know, which is rad.
Yeah, we already have talked to her a bit and are very excited to see her. And it's nice because we see her at cons. We never get to, like, hang out with Mandy or Suze for that
so
matter
busy,
for the most part. Yeah, everyone's so busy.
Everyone's got stuff going on.
You know, so it's nice that... Oh, we're doing so good, brother. Thank you, man. So yeah, it'll be nice to actually be at a small con where we could probably hang out there, maybe like go out to dinner, you know, or whatever, you know, kind of cool stuff. Alrighty. This is awesome.
I'm loving it, man.
Yeah, we're pretty pumped, Merrimack. Pretty darn pumped. So what y'all doing right now, Merrimack? Y'all working on GenCon?
Yeah, what's going on with GenCon?
Y'all just getting everything. What specifically do you do at GenCon, Merrimack? I honestly can't remember off the top of my head. I know you told us at some point.
Merrimack says, hopefully this con's a little more chill. As much as I love GenCon, I have no time to hang out with people or...
Well, yeah, 100%. We literally had to like schedule time. We got lunch with Kristen last year, and it was like we were almost like, hey, this lunch may not happen because it's like it's tough.
Time.
We saw like Derek in the background one point. We're like, hi. It's just like, yeah, it's insane.
Eric says right now I'm working on reviewing events.
Oh, very cool.
That's why you're able to speak on them so eloquently.
That is.
I'm looking at it right now. Yeah,
that makes total awesome. Sense.
I'm just waiting on my person to dry a little before
yeah,
I stand
no
him back up and let it cool. So,
you see, he's
one of these.
He's taking a nap.
Yeah. Mess with the odd blowers much. So,
jeez. I'm actually, at this point, we don't have, there's no like metallic contrast paint, which is also one of the bummers about contrast paint.
So I might just leave the weaponry.
Yeah, I think I'll leave the weaponry because we can always paint that in. But like, honestly, this guy is pretty close to being done. He doesn't look bad. He doesn't look bad.
Yeah.
This morning I was working on MHE events. What's an MHE events? Monster Hunter events. You guys have like ghost hunters in the house? NMM? No, not with... Although you probably could do some kind of NMM with contrast paints. I have a hunch it wouldn't look great, though. Mini historical events. That makes more sense. I like Monster Hunters, though. That's more fun.
That's basically what we're doing right now.
I'm not trying to hunt some monsters. We got the whole Dead Monsters crew here.
That you do.
Including you. You part of it. Especially now, man.
Well,
you are part of our Patreon campaign. It's not even just saying that for funsies. You are a legit part of it.
That's very true. Honored, stoked to be. Baby, you're so
alrighty, doing some touch-ups here because my computer will be dying soon, so we're gonna have to cut it a little bit short. Although my battery lasted long, I was literally like, it's gonna be like an hour-long stream. It actually lasted pretty darn well.
Battery said, "I'll show you."
I know. I'm like, good on you, battery. Way to prove me wrong. It was all reverse psychology.
Bet you this battery will die instantly.
I'll show you. Oh, I can do it. Thanks, battery. Miniature hobby events. Oh, that works out. That's what you're working on. Okay. And you're here watching us. That's awesome. What a fun full circle type thing you would do. So he's got spikes sticking up. I'm gonna paint all those red. Just doing it. Deciding and doing it.
Just straight up going for it.
Job.
Kind of missed and hit the helmet a bit, but we'll
figure that out.
Let me totally bad. Everything turned out fine. Everything turned out fine. I don't think I want to do this helmet. Oh, I need to do this other skull too. Whoops.
Over here cracking it up.
What did I do? It was the skull. Where are you? Did you take the skull coin back?
What?
Skeleton what? Something?
Something.
Golly, what's it called? Skeleton Horde. Look, it has skeleton in the title. What can I say? Contrast Skeleton Horde.
Yes. Get out of here.
Ooh, Merrimack says, I was just reading something from Games Workshop. You can put the contrast paints over metallics.
You can.
That'd be awesome.
It's their one thing, again, my biggest likes about contrast paints is they're really good for glazes. And glazes, for the most part, are you put something over something to tint it. You tend to do a lot of very, 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 very thin layers, and you can tint something really cool, and it's a really cool effect. I've gotten really into glazing lately. And contrast paints are really good for that because they're naturally highly pigmented and very, very thin. Which is what glazes should be.
Is that right?
Is that right? Can't do that here, Mike.
Why? What you on about?
Because we're in the their country.
What you on about then?
What you on about?
No, Mark Cook said, oh, watch the stream, they're going to be doing a bunch of staunchy accents. I said, listen here.
Staunchy.
I said, no. I'm going to do proper.
Ooh, I like that.
Proper.
I'm glad I did that.
See, like this red is, I wish I'd used that red. Because this one's a little dark, a little deep.
But it looks cool. I just wish I could highlight it.
Ooh.
But nonetheless, this looks pretty darn good. Like this guy, I would totally put him on a table, you know? No problem. Yeah, yeah, this guy.
Dude, I love this dude.
This dude's so metal. He looks great. His pants look great.
Oh, some pretty
pants look great. He's happy. Got a. He looks pretty sick. I'm not gonna lie, dude.
Thanks, man. I think, like, you know.
Yeah, with a bit of highlight, this dude could be
tight.
The good choice in the cloth, the cloth thingy.
Yeah, I think it ultimately worked out. I just had to, like, let it set for a second.
That was great, dude.
Miramax says, when people ask me why mini paints are so expensive, I remind them that the level of pigmentation is so much higher than regular paint. That's where a lot of the cost is. I didn't know that.
Okay. Yes.
I mean, that makes sense.
Very,
very pigmented. I didn't think that could figure into the cost.
Yes.
It makes sense that it would.
Yeah. It's really highly pigmented paint. Really high.
That's such a weird thing to me. I'm like, that paint's got a lot of color in it. I'm like, yeah. You're like, no, but like more. And I'm like, what? But it's true. It's just like a...
How is something really, really good coverage
color to it? Yeah, it's just like solid.
You buy like
right?
cheap craft paint. The reason why it's cheap is because it has such low pigmentation. It takes so many layers to get like a smooth thing because like it just doesn't cover very well. Like one of the big issues is like you know like reds tend to be very transparent. Yellows tend to be very transparent. And don't get me wrong, like yellow over black is gonna be hard. But even then, like with mini painted paints, it covers way better than a normal yellow. Because red and yellow tend to be the most transparent paints in general.
But the bottom, this guy's got kind of like a Batman thing. His mouth is exposed.
Oh, he is.
I'm gonna paint that red. I didn't notice that until right now. Yeah, he's kind of got the Judge Dredd thing.
Yeah, craft paint is fine for large terrain, but tiny things need a lot of paper. Yeah, exactly. Terrain stuff, buy craft paint. There's no point. Don't use your mini painting stuff for terrain.
unless you're just doing like a base, this might happen for big terrain. I'm watching a lot of terrain making videos. Oh, it's bad. It's bad.
New
I just
hobby
want to make terrain
the way.
Now. I have no even I have no reason for it. Like I don't even know what I'd use it for.
No, I think simply enjoying making it is plenty of reason enough.
Totally agree. But I'm just like, man, like I don't have the space for something like that. I just don't have it. So we're gonna head now, right? Once Mikey, because my thing is very quickly dying on me. My computer here, but this was incredibly fun. This was so cool. Thank you. Hello. I said, dude, cutting foam with a hot wire set with to make terrain is so satisfying. You're not wrong. You're not wrong. You can do such cool stuff with terrain. Did I just not hit that? Oh, no, that's fine. So thank you so much for being here. This was incredibly cool, incredibly fun. Thank you, GenCon, for having us. Thank you for being willing to work with our schedule while we're here. This
was
super cool.
We very much appreciate
it. And thank you to Drafts in Waterloo in London here for letting us stream here. This is so cool.
Go peep them out. They're really fun. We're going to like just hang out and play some games for a few while other folks are cruising around in museums and stuff like nerds.
Indeed. Hanging out here playing games.
Dude, you know indeed. It. Thanks. I mean, I got pretty far. I got to pretty much everything. I'd want to do metallics a lot of the rest of the way.
Man, like,
so
this dude looks
pretty sweet.
Pretty great. Like, for a skin tone, this is pretty darn good.
I realize I missed a spot or two, but it's fine.
That's fine.
So thank you so much for joining us, everybody. So stay tuned. We're figuring out the rest of the trip. Things are all going to be just a little bit different. We're not streaming on our channel this week, but do give a follow over there because we'll be back once we get back to the States, and then our schedule becomes very regular for quite some time. This was super duper fun. I had so much fun. This is really awesome. I'm just like so happy with how this turned out. So thank you all for being here. And enjoy the rest of your week and weekend. Check us on social media so you see what we're doing at AirCon. If you're going to be at AirCon, say hello.
Yeah, we'll say hi to everyone for you all. Y'all are the best. And we'll see y'all later.
Bye.